Hey guys, what's up? It's the Chinchilla Notebook here and welcome back to my YouTube channel. So today's video is going to be a DIY video and I'm going to be showing you guys how to do DIY paint for your chinchilla. Basically, what I'm going to be doing is going to be showing you how you can dye your chinchilla's huts or their wood or whatever you want to. And I've actually done this before with the hut. So as you can see, this is one of Merlin's older huts and I don't use it anymore because he chewed it up pretty bad. But over here I just put some pineapples on and then I painted the top and then the side blue, and then I also have like a little flower on the side there. So I'm going to be showing you guys how you can do that to your huts or your ledges or anything wooden in their cage. And the reason for this is just adds a personal touch and it just, you know, can be fun for you just to have something spicing up their cage. And of course this is going to be non-toxic and safe for your chinchillas, so don't worry about anything being unsafe for them. And yeah, so let's just jump right into the video. Alright, so you're going to need a bowl, some water, food coloring or food dye, some paint brushes, and yes, I'm using a makeup brush too, just don't get onto that. I'm also using a finer detailed brush, and then you're also going to need your wood. So for the first step, we're just going to be filling our bowl with water, and then you're going to want to choose whatever color you want to use for your first batch of paint, and you're just going to pour a couple drops in there. And I had to add more later on, but this is just what I started out with. How it looks mixed together, and then to test it out I just put a little bit on a piece of wood and let it dry to see if I like the color, and if I thought it was too light then I just added more dye. And if you guys like how it turns out then just leave it like that. Some people like a richer color and then some people also like a pastel color, so it's just up to your preference. Now we're just going to start painting the wood, and I just wanted to show you an example of what I was doing. So I took the larger brush, again, it's the makeup brush, just leave it. I cleaned it up, it's the only one I had in the house. And I basically just started painting so that you guys can kind of see what it looks like. And I just want to let you know that you're going to have to let it dry between layers. Obviously, the more layers you do, the darker it's going to be. And another thing I wanted to mention is this also bleeds into the wood a little bit, which you'll see later on, but that's just kind of unprepared. Now another option, if you actually want to make art and make it kind of cute, is to draw on your wood and then paint it. And so here I'm just kind of freehanding it, and again I'm really like not good at crafts or drawing or anything, so just kind of ignore the fact that I don't even know what that looks like. But yeah, you could just do that and get creative with what you want. You could also do like stencils so that you can actually make it look good. And as you can see, I'm doing here's an example of how the paint might bleed a little bit, but honestly it shouldn't be that much of a big deal, so just kind of get used to that. I think it actually kind of adds a little bit of an abstract look to it. I think it's kind of unique and cool, plus like I said, you can't really do anything about it, so might as well just like Now if you want a really opaque color, you can actually just use direct dye and literally just take your brush and use it like this, and I'm just going to be putting it right on there. Obviously this is going to bleed really, really bad, more than it would with the water, but honestly this is just so easy to use and it just brings that color in there right away. So that is definitely an option that you can choose. Okay guys, so as you can see, this is the finished product, and I do realize that it looks a little messy, but that's just because it bled through. Obviously, if you use a little bit more precision, it won't. But as you can see, I just put a couple of the little sample colors. I just quickly patted those on there. So this is more like a pastel, and if you want to build color, you just either add more on like that, or you can just put the dye straight onto like I did on the petals. But either way, this is just an example of what you guys can do to get your wood to be dyed, and it just makes their cage a little funner. Now, I just did it on this one little piece of wood to show you how to do it, but you guys can do it on your huts, you can do it on your ledges, or anything else in the cage that you would like to. Come up here. So guys, that is it for the video. I hope you enjoyed it, and let me know down below if you try out this DIY, and let me know how it went. I will see you guys in my next video. And everybody knows.